Hello friends, welcome to Quick Learn tutorial series. In this video, I will explain you class D commutation of SCR, its circuit diagram, working and waveform. This is lecture number 47 of power electronics series. So let's start with the topic. Before I discuss class D commutation, we must know about what do you mean by commutation. Commutation is basically a process of turning off the device. Or in terms of SCR, the turn off process of SCR is known as SCR commutation. If we turn off SCR with the help of external circuitry, that turn off process is called force commutation. So class D commutation is basically a technique of force commutation to turn off the SCR. Now class D commutation is also known as voltage commutation, because in class D commutation, if we want to turn off the main thyristor, we apply a reverse bias voltage across it and thyristor get turned off. That is why it is called voltage commutation. It is also known as auxiliary commutation, because in class D commutation circuit, here we use a auxiliary thyristor. With the help of this thyristor, we turn off the main thyristor. That is why it is called auxiliary commutation circuit. It is also referred as parallel plate capacitor commutation, because here we see in the circuit diagram of class D commutation, here we use a capacitor and the voltage across capacitor will turn off the main SCR. That is why it is also called as parallel plate capacitor commutation. So these are some basics of class D commutation. Now we discuss the circuit diagram of class D commutation. Here we see in the circuit diagram, here we use a DC supply voltage Vs at the input side. Why we use DC supply at the input side? Because we know that class D commutation is come under the category of force commutation. And in any force commutation circuit, we use DC supply at the input side. That is why here we use a DC supply voltage Vs at the input side of the circuit. Here we also use two thyristor T1 and TA. T1 is the main thyristor and TA is the auxiliary thyristor. By using this auxiliary thyristor, we turn off the main thyristor. That is why it is called auxiliary commutation circuit. Some other component is also here we use, just like capacitor, diode, inductor and load. So this is the whole circuit diagram of class D commutation. Now I'll explain you the operation of class D commutation. To easily understand the operation of class D commutation, here we take two assumptions. First assumption is the load current is constant. It means the output current across load is always constant. And the second assumption is the capacitor is initially charged with supply voltage Vs. By taking these two assumptions, we easily understand the working of class D commutation. Now, let's start the working of class D commutation. This is the circuit diagram as I have already explained. In step 1, initially we assume that both the thyristor is turned off. It means T1 and auxiliary thyristor TA is turned off in step 1. And initially capacitor is not charged with any voltage. So there is no path through which we charge the capacitor. So if we want to charge capacitor, because we already assumed that capacitor is initially charged with plus Vs voltage. So to charge capacitor, first we turn on the auxiliary thyristor TA. To turn on TA thyristor, we apply a gate triggering pulse to auxiliary thyristor and TA will turn on. When TA will turn on, it behaves like a short circuit and current flow through supply voltage Vs through capacitor, TA thyristor, load and back to the supply voltage. It means current follow this path. When current follow this path, capacitor is start charging with Vs supply voltage. And when capacitor is completely charged with Vs supply voltage, the polarity across capacitor is upper plate positive and lower plate is negative. This time, this polarity of capacitor will turn off the TA thyristor, because this time auxiliary thyristor anode is connected from the negative of the capacitor. Okay, so here we see this polarity of capacitor will turn off the auxiliary thyristor TA, and TA is behave like a open circuit. After that, we turn on the main thyristor T1. When we turn on main thyristor T1, T1 behave like a short circuit. This time, current flow in this circuit via two loops. First loop is from supply voltage Vs, T1 thyristor, through load and back to the supply voltage. This is first loop through which current flow in the circuit. And the second loop is through capacitor, T1 thyristor, inductor, diode and back to the capacitor. This is the second path of current or second loop. Here we see when T1 thyristor is turned on, here this L or C connect in series and make a series resonant circuit. And through this resonant circuit, a resonant current will flow. So here we know the response of the resonant circuit like this. Positive, negative, positive, negative. So during the positive half cycle of resonant current or the resonant circuit current, diode is forward bias. In this time, when capacitor releases its energy, inductor stores some charge. And when inductor stores some charge, the polarity across inductor is left side plate is negative and right side plate is positive. And when inductor is fully charged with some energy, the capacitor voltage is equals to zero that time. After that, inductor will release its energy. So here we see when inductor releases its energy, it changes polarity. So here inductor changes its polarity, and in this direction inductor releases its energy through diode and capacitor. And capacitor again charged with minus Vs voltage. So here we see capacitor initially charged with plus Vs voltage, and when current flow through loop 2, capacitor charged with minus Vs voltage. Now the polarity across capacitor this time is upper plate is negative and lower plate is positive. This polarity of capacitor will turn off the main thyristor T1, and T1 get turn off and behave like a open circuit. Now we turn on TA thyristor, auxiliary thyristor, by applying gate triggering pulse. When we apply gate triggering pulse to TA thyristor, TA is behave like a short circuit. And when TA behave like a short circuit, again current flow from supply voltage through capacitor, auxiliary thyristor, load back to the supply voltage. It means current follow this path. When current follow this path, capacitor again charged with Vs supply voltage. It means this time capacitor polarity is upper plate is positive and lower plate negative, and capacitor voltage is equals to Vs. So here we see we again came to our initial condition. So this is the whole working of glass decommutation circuit. Now I will explain this working with the help of waveform. So here this is the circuit diagram of glass decommutation circuit. As I have already explained you, Vs is the DC supply voltage. Here we use two thyristor, T1 and TA. T1 is the main thyristor and TA is the auxiliary thyristor, through which we turn off T1 thyristor. Here we also use other component just like capacitor, diode, inductor and load. Here we take two assumption to understand the operation of class D commutation. First assumption is load current is constant, and the second assumption is capacitor is initially charged with Vs supply voltage. Okay, now we have to draw this waveform. Here IG1 is the gate current for thyristor T1, IGA is the gate current for thyristor TA, VT1 and IT1 is the voltage and current of thyristor T1, VC and IC is the voltage and current across capacitor, and I0 is the output current across load. So we already assumed that capacitor is initially charged with Vs supply voltage. So the polarity across capacitor is upper plate is positive and lower plate is negative. Now at T is equals to 0, here we give a gate triggering pulse to thyristor T1. And when we apply gate triggering pulse to thyristor T1, T1 T1 get turned on. And when T1 get turned on, is behave like a short circuit. So here we give gate triggering pulse at T equal to 0 to thyristor T1, and T1 is behave like a short circuit. T1 get turned on. When T1 get turned on, there is two loop through which current flow through the circuit. First loop is from VS battery, T1 thyristor, load and back to the battery. Okay, this is first loop. When current flow from first loop, the output current is equal to the loop current or the supply current. Both the magnitude is same. And the second loop is from capacitor, because capacitor we assume that initially charged with VS supply voltage. So capacitor is discharged in this time, and the second current flow through capacitor. So second loop is from capacitor, T1 thyristor, inductor, diode and back to capacitor. So here we see when current flow through loop 2 or T1 thyristor get turned on, inductor and capacitor is connect in series and make LC resonant circuit. Due to this LC resonant circuit, a resonant current flow across the loop 2. And we know that the response of resonant current is just like this. Positive, negative, positive, negative. This will produce a oscillation. So during the positive half cycle of the resonant current, the diode is forward bias and current flow through capacitor, inductor, diode and back to the capacitor. This time inductor will store some energy, because we know that the property of inductor, when current flow through the inductor, inductor stores some energy. So this time left terminal is negative and right terminal is positive. After that, inductor will release its energy. So when inductor releases its energy, it changes polarity. So the polarity across inductor that time is left plate is positive and right plate negative. Inductor releases energy in this direction, and inductor that time delivers its whole energy to the capacitor, and capacitor is charged with minus VS voltage. It means capacitor polarity is upper plate is negative and lower plate is positive this time. But what happened during the negative half cycle? During the negative half cycle of oscillation current, diode D is reverse bias and no current will flow through loop 2. Now this whole we draw in the waveform. So here we see at T equals to 0, we apply a gate triggering pulse to thyristor T1 and T1 get turned on. This time T1 is turned on, that is why the voltage across T1 thyristor is 0. Because we know that if any device is turned on, there is no voltage drop across the device. So VT1 is 0 this time. What about current across T1? So here we see when T1 get turned on, two current flow through T1 from loop 1 or loop 2. So the total current flow through T1 is loop 1 current I0 or loop 2 current from capacitor. So I0 plus IC. Here we see in loop 2, inductor is also connected in series with capacitor. So here we get sinusoidal waveform during positive half cycle of IC current, because inductor is present here in loop 2. What happened during the negative half cycle of resonant current? So during negative half cycle of LC resonant circuit current, loop 2 current becomes 0. Because diode is reverse bias this time. And when loop 2 current becomes 0, only loop 1 current flow through T1 thyristor, that is equals to I0. So this is the negative half cycle duration of resonant current. Now we draw the waveform of voltage across capacitor and current. So initially we assume that the capacitor is initially charged with plus VS voltage. So here capacitor is initially charged with plus VS voltage. When T1 get turned on, current flow in this direction, capacitor is charged with minus VS voltage. Okay, so here we see initially capacitor is charged with plus VS voltage. When T1 get turned on, capacitor is charged with minus VS voltage. Okay, and after that capacitor hold minus VS voltage for some time. What about current? So here we see in loop second, during the positive half cycle of resonant current, current flow through capacitor, inductor, diode. This time I not current flow across the capacitor. But during the negative half cycle of resonant circuit, there is no current flow through the loop 2. Loop 2 current is 0. So here loop 2 current is 0 this time. Now what about output current? So we assume that the output current is constant and the magnitude of output current is initially I0. After that, when T1 is turned on, the current flow through loop 1 across the load. So I0 current is equals to loop current. So the magnitude of I0 is equals to I0, which is constant. So this is the waveform of mode 1. Now mode 2 operation. In mode 2, at the end of mode 1, here we see capacitor is charged with minus Vs voltage and the polarity across capacitor is upper plate negative, lower plate positive. This polarity of capacitor will turn off T1 thyristor because this time the anode of the T1 is connected from negative of the capacitor. This time we turn on TA thyristor by applying a gate triggering pulse. So here we apply a gate triggering pulse to thyristor TA and TA get turned on and behave like a short circuit. Here we see in the waveform at time instant T1, we apply gate triggering pulse to thyristor TA and TA get turned on. This time T1 get turned off due to the polarity of capacitor. Okay, and capacitor behave like a open circuit. When TA get turned on, current flow through supply voltage, capacitor, TA thyristor, load back to the supply voltage in this direction. When current flow in this direction, capacitor is charged with again plus Vs voltage. Upper plate is positive, lower plate is negative and the capacitor voltage is equals to plus Vs voltage this time. Now we draw the waveform. Here we see at time instant T1, we apply a gate triggering pulse to thyristor TA and TA get turned on. This time T1 get turned off. First we draw the waveform of voltage and current across T1 thyristor. Here we see first the at time instant T1, the voltage across T1 thyristor is minus Vs. Now when T1 get turned off and TA get turned on, the voltage across T1 thyristor is minus Vs to plus Vs. Now current across T1 thyristor is, T1 thyristor is turned off, so there is no current flow across T1 thyristor. So the current is 0 this time. Now what about capacitor voltage? So at time instant T1, here we see initially capacitor is charged with minus Vs voltage at time instant T1. Now when TA thyristor get turned on, current flow in this direction. And capacitor again charged with plus Vs voltage. So here T1 time instant, capacitor is charged with minus Vs voltage. And when TA get turned on, capacitor is charged with plus Vs voltage. So at time instant T2, capacitor is charged with plus Vs voltage. And when capacitor is charged with plus Vs voltage, this polarity of capacitor will turn off the TA thyristor. So TA thyristor is turned off at time instant T. So the voltage across capacitor is maintained, that is equals to Vs. Now what about current? At time instant T1, the current across capacitor is minus I0. At time instant T2, when TA is turned off, current is 0 across the capacitor because there is no path to discharge the capacitor at time instant T2 when TA get turned off. Now what about I0 current? So at time instant T1 when TA get turned on, I0 is constant, but at time instant T2 when TA and T1 both get turned off, no current flow across the circuit. So output current is also equals to 0. So this is the whole working of class D commutation. One point I want to clear that. Here we see this is the sinusoidal waveform and these are the linear waveform. Why we got linear waveform after time instant T1? Because after time instant T1, current only flow through capacitor. There is no involvement of inductor. But at mode 1, there is a involvement of inductor. L and C is connect in series and make a series resonant circuit. Due to inductor, here we get sinusoidal waveform at mode 1. But after time instant T1, the inductor involvement is 0. That is why we got linear wave. So this is the whole working of class D commutation circuit. If you like the video, please like, subscribe and share my channel. For notes, please visit my website. The link of the website I will give in my description box and display here also www.quick-learn.in.